Always trying to choke the person. And I always try to trap the close side arm. But for the move right now, I'm just going to take his back, yank him over, and get hooks. It's not amazing for that part. There's a submission that can happen after it. There's a couple submissions that can happen after it that are exciting that most people don't know. Now, from here, this hand comes down like I'm going to choke. I'm going to grab, I'm going to grab this for right now. I'm not saying I don't choke you. I'm saying right now I'm doing this, okay? We're here. I go down. I lock. This knee is going to check this corner of his body. So be aware, guys. Don't smash your knee on their fingers. Here. Self-defense, obviously, you need in the face. And then you come in here. Look, I'm going to check this corner of his body. I'm going to smash his head down with my shoulder. I'm going to yank him over. I'm going to fall over to my hip and yank. The more this person is concerned about the situation and kind of scared or stiff, the better it works. When I yank him over, I'm going to throw this knee over his shoulder. I'm going to cross my feet. My arms are going to be inside my legs. I'm going to squeeze and crank him. And it's going to tap him out one way. So I'm here. I dive this under. This goes here. I catch. Smash. Done. Now, if I couldn't finish with both of my forearm blades smashing his neck in with my legs reinforced and helping, I got my angle wrong. But no big deal. If I got my angle wrong, grab my ankle, put on the hip, shift out, lock, finish with a reverse triangle. If that didn't work, grab my knee to get out. They're going to be doing this. They're going to be peeling away. So grab those four fingers, smash them in, peel it back. You can do that cool armbar steeple you did a minute ago, right here. So, but anyway, you just grab this thing, bang, done. Got it. If I were concerned about him coming up, I would guide this around and bring him up into the regular triangle. But we're going to look at one thing at a time.